We know that the foundation of any safety program is a hazard assessment. You need to know what the hazards are to be able to control them effectively. The same applies to traffic-related hazards. Determine where people and mobile equipment move through your workspace. Then examine your high-risk areas, such as where people must cross a lift truck aisleway. Consider how this interaction can be done safely. Can you eliminate people where lift trucks move? Would you benefit from installing a hard barrier between your people and mobile equipment? Do you have designated pedestrian walkways that keep people separate? Do your pedestrians consistently stop, look, and listen before crossing an aisleway? Have you established who has the right of way? Now, although pedestrians usually have the right of way, they also have the most to lose. So people must make eye contact with a lift truck operator and wait for a hand gesture before walking across an aisle. Are your pathways blocked so that either people or equipment must now move into each other's space to avoid the obstacle? Do high pallet loads at intersections create blind spots? Are you using the right type of lift truck equipment that has safety features such as blue light that projects a beam to warn pedestrians of an operator's presence before the lift truck can be seen? Would your workspace benefit from one-way traffic flow to reduce congestion? So conduct a complete analysis of all of your traffic safety issues, then formalize your controls in writing, including expected behaviors. Your written program will only work if you communicate, train, monitor, and enforce your documented safety procedures with all your employees.